You two pop out. You two pop out. Always want great spacing, okay? And you two freeze. Whoever you throw it to, so say you throw it to this side of the court, you always pop out same side. So your gun is loaded, your hands are ready. We got great spacing here, okay? There's an exchange. So eventually you want to get the ball back to you. You're my point guard. Come to the top, you rotate over. And now, on the exchange now, you're my best shooter, so you're going to set a great screen for him. So throw the ball. This is the basic wide premise. Throw the ball, I'm setting the screen. As the ball leaves his hands, go right down to the low block, and then there's a pin down right here by you. And get back to three out, two in. And I'm hunting a jump shot here. He's looking to hunt the post, and we're in this set. All right, we're in this set. So bring it back out. So this is our wide set, and I'm gonna stay with me here with this. We can run it to the right, or we can run it to the left. All high school teams, I watch high school teams play. If you run 10 plays, 10 of them are to the right side. Switch your stuff up. Throw the ball to the left. Throw the ball to the left. Throw the ball to the left. Now you guys are cutting back to the right, which helps them and stuff. Start your stuff on the left-hand side. And it's easy for this defender to choke out right-handed side because he sees it every end. Choke out. Start stuff on the left. All right, so with this wide series, we can run it from the right or the left. And I had to do that because my first year, I would throw the pass. He would pop out lazy. This guy was a bad passer. 2 points for the other team. My offense was the best offense for the other team. So now I said, shoot, we better throw it to left. We better throw it to left a bunch of times. All right, we better ball fake right, throw left. So now, same action now on wide. He pops out. Now you're throwing it this way. Always strong side. Hands are ready. All right, right there. And now you're going to become the back screen guy. Quick ball reversal. And the timing is such as the ball leaves his hands. So I'm going to give you guys great teaching technique. Here's the timing. As the ball leaves his hands, Now you got to be setting that screen. Now when the ball leaves his hands on the catch, boom, he should be open there in the post. Boom, great pin down. Boom, pop up, hunt the jump shot. Okay, that is the wide series. Get back into it. A lot of options out of it, just by changing words. So, if we want to go with a wide, and so as teams start playing us, pop out. Let's walk through it again. Ball gets passed. Ball goes out. Freeze. All right. As we get better now, teams would start to choke this pass here. They would start choking this and get us. So now, I say, I know they're doing that, so we're going to have great spacing, so I'm going to go wide, same side. He's going to pass it to the same side he's on. So now you two have two-man game right here. So you ball fake over there, because you know, and you let that defense stretch way out, so you got great spacing. Now you two guys have two-man game on this side. So I have action if I go pass and follow. This is passive. If I go pass and follow, the minute I get within 4 feet of him, I'm always slipping. So if pass and follow, I'm slipping. Pass and follow, I'm slipping. So if that's my action, you can have any action. If I go wide, same side, sure. Okay? That means he's going back door. So wide, same side, sure. So they're overplaying this lane too. So now I get him here, and as soon as he catches the ball, he looks at him, one dribble, boom, back door. That's wide. Same side, sure. Just by changing your language. So I'm on the sideline, wide. Same side, sure. They all know, they know the vocabulary. That's the action that we come off of, okay?